Bless you, brothers and sisters. Jesus Christ is Lord. Jesus Christ is come in the flesh. I just want to jump into the message, and it's about the demons are still asking the same question today as they did back in Jesus' time. So one of my a great account in Acts is the seven sons of Sceva. You guys may know this story. If you don't, you're in for a treat. Acts 19, verse 12. So that from his body were brought unto the sick handkerchiefs or aprons, and the diseases departed from them, and the evil spirits went out of them. Then certain of the vagabond Jews, exorcists, took upon them to call over them which had evil spirits the name of the Lord Jesus, saying, We adjure you by Jesus whom Paul preacheth. And there were seven sons of one Sceva, a Jew and chief of the priests, which did so. And the evil spirit answered and said, Jesus I know, and Paul I know, but who are ye? Who are you? And the man in whom the evil spirit leapt on them, and overcame them, and prevailed against them, so that they fled out of that house naked and wounded. And this was known to all the Jews and Greeks also dwelling at Ephesus, and fear fell on them all, and the name of the Lord Jesus was magnified. So this guy gets his butt kicked by a demon, and Jesus Christ is magnified. And many that believed came and confessed and showed their deeds. Many also of them which used curious arts brought their books together and burned them before all men, and they counted the price of them and found it 50,000 pieces of silver. So mightily grew the word of God and prevailed. So here comes some Jews, I'm assuming to make some money or some profit, are basically watching Paul do this. And so I looked up Sceva and blueletterbible.org, and it said mind reader. I don't know where they came up with that, but it may make sense considering that this mind reader tries to go do what Paul is doing in his demonic power, and he gets his butt kicked. So that's why Jesus Christ's name is glorified, is because you need Jesus Christ in order to deal with these spirits. And so any witches out there or warlocks, you are serving a lesser god. The power that you have is a lesser power than what Christians have through Jesus Christ. And that should be a warning to witches and warlocks, because they do get killed when they come up against Christians who know who they are in Jesus Christ. And so in my deliverances, quite a bit of the deliverances, I usually work my way up to the strong man, or the strong man comes up first, or in the middle. But, you know, some of these demons that I've talked to or confronted have been demons over cities, have been demons over states, and have even been demons over countries and even continents, okay? One of the demons' name was General, okay? And he was a death demon, darkness, and pretty powerful, okay? And needless to say, he asked me the same question. Basically, who do you think you are? Who are you? You know, and I get that question a lot doing deliverances. A lot of times the demons are like, who do you think you are? What, you know, how do you think you can do this to me? Do you know who I am? And quite mockingly and arrogant, these demons have never come across a Christian who has taken the power and the authority of Jesus Christ and has exercised it and destroyed their kingdom in a matter of hours. So that question is still being asked today. And, you know, a lot of people take this verse and say, well, obviously, you know, the seven sons of Sceva didn't have Jesus, and therefore they got their butts kicked. Well, that's true, but that question is still being asked to Christians. It's still being asked to you. Maybe not directly. And I pray one day it is asked directly to you. In fact, if you never talked to a demon or confronted a demon, I highly encourage it. That's probably one of the most rewarding experiences, is to talk face to face with a demon and see it bow to the name of Jesus Christ. But first we need to answer that question. So when the demon asks you, who are you, or who do you think you are? I know Paul and I know Jesus Christ, but who are you? What is your answer? Or do you think it's just automatic that, well, demons know that you're a Christian and they won't touch you? Well, we know that's not true. So what is the answer? What would you answer? Here's my answer. Demon, I am an ambassador of Jesus Christ. Look around you. For the last 2 hours, your kingdom has been laid waste. Such and such demon has been here for 4 generations. This demon over here was here for 10 generations, for 400 years. And where is that demon now? And the demon will say, in the abyss, or in Tartarus, or being tortured, whatever. And even these demons will lie. Well, you can't do this. Oh, really? Confess in the name of Jesus Christ that you are defeated. Yeah, I'm defeated. Jesus Christ defeated you at the cross. Confess that to be true. Yeah, that's true. So they will mock, they will laugh, they will scorn, they will puff up, and even maybe put on a display of power. But all of that is a lie. The fact in the matter is that you are an ambassador of Jesus Christ. Mark 16, those who believe in my name will cast out devils. Okay? Granted, some people ask, well, should you speak in tongues? And do you need to be, you know, baptized by the Holy Spirit? I say the more armor and weapons that you have to go on the front line, that's what you need. But if I was to boil down anything, that answer is what you need that is going to differentiate you between somebody else who doesn't have the authority to cast out devils. This is all by faith. If you do not believe, not just parrot the talk, not just say, well, you know, archangel said that I'm the ambassador of Jesus Christ, so therefore, you know, that's what these guys were doing. They were parroting Paul. They don't know what they're talking about. They were watching an action, kind of like how you hear tongues, people speak in tongues, and you hear them say the same thing. I never understood that. You know, are they parroting other people's tongues? Are we to say that the heavenly language of God, you know, or the angelic language, whatever people say tongues are, you know, it's basically the Holy Spirit praying through you. But the Holy Spirit only has a few words in his vocabulary. It just never made sense to me. So don't parrot it. You need to know who you are in Jesus Christ. I am an ambassador of Jesus Christ. I am in his stead. He has given me the authority and the keys to bind and loose in his name. That's who I am. All right? And that's, you need to believe that. And if you believe that, then that, I would say, is what makes a good deliverance minister. And that is the power that you walk in. If you want to say, I have a doctorate of divinity and I've been a pastor for 35 years. That's who I am. Prepare to get your butt kicked. Okay? And like I said, even though you're not talking to demons directly, you are still being asked that question today in your daily life. When you see your kids strung out on drugs, there's a demon there saying, who do you think you are? And they lie to you. Or when you get cancer, or when you get a cold, or whatever. That's a demon saying, who do you think you are? And just like a kid, they're going to push the limits until you say, hey, enough is enough. This is who I am, based on the Word of God, okay? The difference between me and a Word of Faith movement is that my faith is the Word of God, what it says, all right? I don't say, you know, angels come bring me checks and random people to give me money in my cash, you know, account. That's not in the Word of God. So to have faith in something because I proclaim it is foolishness. But if you find it in the Word of God, you plant your flag in that and you proclaim it, claim it, whatever you want to say. That's the difference between me and a Word of Faith. If you find it in the Word of God, yeah, you claim it and you proclaim it and you believe it. That's what faith is. Another point. These demons, when somebody is a rapist or somebody, let's say somebody intends to murder you or to come beat you up, that's a demonic, that takes a demon to have a person do that. Even you as a Christian, I know it's true for me. If I give over into my lust and into my flesh, I can feel a spirit driving me. A lot, obviously more so, you know, before I was delivered. But you can almost feel the evilness that you give into when you try to fulfill your lust, whatever it is, food, sex, alcohol, smoking, anger, violence, whatever it is, you can feel that something is moving you in that direction. So what do you think happens to a non-Christian? They're definitely being moved. So in that attitude, I want you guys to be encouraged. And I think God is answering my prayers. But let's go to another verse. So Acts 13. So Paul comes into a town, and here comes a sorcerer, all right? Acts 13, verses 8 and 11. But Elymas, the sorcerer, for so is his name by interpretation, withstood them, seeking to turn away the deputy from the faith. Then Saul, who also is called Paul, filled with the Holy Ghost, set his eyes on him and said, O full of all subtlety and all mischief, thou child of the devil, thou enemy of all righteousness, will thou not cease to pervert the right ways of the Lord? And now behold, the hand of the Lord is upon thee, and thou shalt be blind, not seeing the sun for a season. And immediately there fell on him a mist and a darkness, and he went about seeking some to lead him by the hand. Then the deputy, when he saw what was done, believed, being astonished at the doctrine of the Lord. So here again, here is power overcoming the enemy, and people believe and have faith in Jesus Christ. That is a prayer taken directly from the Bible. He says, the Bible says exactly what Paul prayed there. So we can bind demons, right? And I even bind their tongues from speaking. And in Jesus Christ, I bind the tongues right now. And I pray, and I loose the spirit of truth. And I pray that the Holy Spirit shows you what is bone and what is meat. So if there's a demoniac or a person who has a rape spirit or lust spirit or violence spirit or murder spirit coming after you and want to take away your freedom or want to attack your family, I would say that they're demonically led. So if you can bind them, why don't you bind the strong man, bind their eyes, and say, hey, you're coming against the ambassador of Jesus Christ. The Lord is against you. The Lord's hand is against you. You will not see the sun for a time. Whatever. Be led by the Holy Spirit. From now on, when there's violent situations or something that's not right that's coming on, I'm starting to speak in tongues, guys, in public, out loud. I don't care. All right? That is the attitude and that is the discipline that I believe that the Holy Spirit is leading me into in these last days. I can feel that the demoniacs are getting more and more evil, and they're seeing who is not a part of their matrix. They know. All right? And I believe if I've been in God's will, I'm living what I need to do, and I still have a mission on this earth, I do believe I'm invincible. I do believe one time God will give me over into their hands, and I'll be murdered, martyred, tortured, whatever. I'm aware of that. And the Lord has been preparing me since I've been a young person for that. If you want to call me a non-Christian and a deviant and, you know, all this stuff, that's fine. But I need you to understand that you're not me and I'm not you, okay? Do you really think that God doesn't have multiple plans for us, for the body? And I'm going to do another video on that because I'm tired of people who aren't treated. God doesn't treat them a certain way, but he treats another child, a servant, another way, and they call them wrong. I think God has multiple responsibilities and roles for all of his children, and they're different. They're different. I just want to leave that with you guys. You need to know who you are, all right? Underneath his authority, stay there. Stay in the shadow of his wings, all right? That is your identity. 1 John 5:18, okay? Please, memorize it. The enemy cannot touch you. Psalms 91, the enemy, you have power, guys. You have power, all right? And it's dangerous for witches and warlocks to come against you if you know who you are in the kingdom, all right? We bless them in the name of Jesus Christ. We bless those who curse us. But if we break that curse, then that demon goes back to sender, all right? And witches and warlocks, it's dangerous for them. It's not dangerous for us, okay? It's dangerous for us if you have wide open doors and you know, you're all into Harry Potter and witchcraft and you know, you keep on inviting the evil, you're double-minded. It's probably dangerous for you then. But get clean. Know who you are in Christ. Start stepping out. I encourage you to talk to a demon. I encourage you to rile up a demonic person. Talk to the demon. Know who you are in Jesus Christ. Find out if that demon has a legal right. And if it doesn't, cast it out. And if it does, demand what it is. What is that legal right, demon, to this person? Oh, they don't forgive their mom. Whatever. Okay? Bring that person back. Mary, come forward. You need to forgive your mom. Mary forgives her mom. You bring the demon back. Hey, do you have legal right now? No. Okay, so name Jesus Christ. You know, look to Jesus. Where is he sending you? Oh, he's sending me to the abyss, to Tartarus, to hell, wherever. And then send him there. In the name of Jesus Christ, go to the abyss. It's very simple, guys. You have to step out. We're never going to be perfect before. I'm learning all the time. I have made a lot of mistakes. I'm going to make more. But I'm going to continue to move forward and cast out devils. The devil's a liar. He's the father of all lies. Okay? So his demons are liars as well. Part of that lying is that they will puff themselves up, do a sign of power, show of force, whatever, to get you off your game. All right? It's okay to feel fear, you know, at the inset. Right? I mean, if a demon pops up or whatever, it's okay to feel fear, that we're just human, all right? But what do we choose after that moment? So just like a dog, guys, these demons or demoniacs, they're going to bristle, they're going to bark, they're going to do a show of power. If you stand your ground, you'll win. If you stand your ground in truth. If you run, you know, you give in to your fear, you run, you turn your back on your enemy, you're going to get snatched. Fear the Lord. I don't fear you. So I'm the ambassador of Jesus Christ. Leave now in the name of Jesus Christ. You know, or if that demon's in a person, you bind that person or you bind the strong man in that person, you know, be led by the Holy Spirit. You have power. All right. We need to test these things because it's only going to get worse, guys. It's only going to get worse. And for those Christians who like to say, you know, look at this demon. Oh, look at big things it has. Look at the big talons it has. Look how powerful this demon is. You know, we need to fear this demon that's coming on this earth. Look how crazy it is. Look how its eyes, its beady red eyes. Look how crazy it is. I rebuke you for that. In the name of Jesus Christ, I rebuke you for that. Demons are defeated. I don't care how big they are. I don't care how ugly they are. I don't care how powerful they are. They are defeated by Jesus Christ. We are taught to fear Jesus Christ and Him alone we fear. Okay? We fear the Lord God Almighty. So Christians who are trying to spread fear by pointing at the devil and trying to tell other Christians how sharp those teeth are, I rebuke you. You need to be telling the Christians who they are through Jesus Christ. And by His power. I love you. Stay strong. Know who you are. Find the diamonds, find the gold, find the silver in the Word of God. Stand on it. Watch your life change. God bless.